Today I have two smartphones that should have been slated for release in the year 2040. However, I imagine Red Magic decided to release these guys early since it looks like humanity ain't gonna make it that far. This is the Red Magic 10 Pro, and it's the most powerful gaming smartphone I have ever laid eyes on. On the left, we have the aptly named Dusk, and on the right, we have Moonlight. And like I always say, the best camera bump is no camera bump. And this back panel is as smooth as the brains at a flat earth convention. Moonlight is about to go through some things, and I'll set aside Dusk to be given away at the end of the video. See, a hallmark tradition of Red Magic gaming phones are that they have an internal RGB cooling fan. And this Red Magic 10 is no different. You can see the RGB spool up the FPS's and hear the 23,000 RPMs whiz into action. Which, when combined with the world's first mobile liquid metal internal cooling system, normally only found in gaming laptops, the internal core temperature of this phone can be lowered by 21 degrees. We will most definitely have to see what that looks like from the inside, but for now, it's cool seeing cool phones do cool things while actively cooling down the internals. The fan is penetratable by determined explorers through the exhaust vent, which is probably why there is no official IP rating on this thing, but when we take a look inside, we'll see how much protection it actually has. One thing you might not have noticed yet, either because it's hidden so well or because your attention to detail has been destroyed by TikTok, there is no front camera notch, nor any front camera hole punch. While still 100% having a concealed 16-megapixel camera below those pixels, which is exactly what I would expect a phone from 2024 to look like. See, in the past, that hole punch area above a hidden selfie camera was filled by a really small secondary screen that had ultra-low resolution pixels spaced farther apart so the camera could see through the pixels. This time around though, Red Magic has mind-blowingly created a manufacturing process that makes the secondary screen indistinguishable from the main screen, even on a microscopic level. You can see the super thin top bezel of the screen, and we can enhance our way down through the layers. Red Magic says creating this new hidden camera display requires 20 unique steps, and 13 more production processes than an average screen, and takes 3 times longer to produce, but has turned out some pretty impressive results. I mean, take a look for yourself. Yeah, the subject is just naturally flawless, but the camera can pick up the individual hairs in my eyebrows. It unfortunately doesn't pick up any hair on my head, but let's solve one problem at a time. As of right now, Red Magic is successfully producing a usable hidden underscreen camera. As we gaze on the display, you might have observed that the bezels are incredibly thin. I don't want to step on any toes or anything, but a top-of-the-line iPhone 16 Pro has a screen-to-body ratio of 90.1%, and this Red Magic 10 Pro has an absolutely wild 95.3% screen-to-body ratio. As per usual, Apple has some catching up to do, but don't worry too much, Tim. We still see scratches at a level 6 with deeper grooves at a level 7. There is a razor-thin earpiece slit up near the top edge of the frame. The bezels are so tiny that the earpiece slit almost doesn't fit, which is actually a really cool problem to have. Moving over to the frame of the phone, there is a whole lot going on. The body is aluminum, and here on the right side, or the top side when held horizontally, are the dual shoulder triggers. These guys can sense finger touches at 520 times per second. No more blaming hardware when you lose. We also have the exhaust port for the turbofan where all that air comes out, the aluminum volume rocker, and a circular power button, along with a dedicated gaming button, which can instantly max out the phone's performance while disabling notifications. I am happy to report that humans from the future have re-embraced the headphone jack, very demure and mindful of them. The remaining long side of the phone has a whole lot more aluminum, and the intake port where the turbofan sucks in air. The bottom of the Red Magic 10 Pro has, and this is true, a 100-watt USB-C charging port that feeds a whopping 7,050 mAh internal battery. That's twice the capacity of an iPhone in just one single charge. I know each spec of this phone is more mind-blowing than the last, but here we are with our minds getting blown. There is no SD card slot though, which is unfortunate. Fun fact, the internal cooling fan can be programmed to kick on while charging at that 100 watts, which helps keep the dual battery cells cool while juicing up. You can tell it's a dual cell by the subtle battery layout on the back design. You know, the kind of details you only notice if you're subscribed here to Jerry Rig Everything. The 50 megapixel wide angle camera is up top, and the normal 50 megapixel camera is in the center, sitting right above the RGB turbofan. There is a 2 megapixel depth camera positioned off to the side under the single tone LED flash. All the camera lenses are completely flush, with no bumps or humps whatsoever. The transparent aesthetic appears to be more cosmetic than literal, but I'm here for it. Transparent tech is still the best tech. When it comes time for the burn test, the Red Magic phones are still the only phones capable of fighting back, blowing out my lighter like it's their birthday. Which is technically true. Let's just hope this first birthday is not their last birthday. The true wall-to-wall full-screen display is 6.85 inches, has a 1.5K resolution, and 2,000 nits of brightness. Refreshing at 144Hz and sensing finger touches at a mind-blowing 2,500Hz. Mobile hardware has now officially surpassed human reaction time. The AMOLED pixels do start to burn at 15 seconds under the heat from my lighter and do not recover. If there was a lesson to be learned from the burn test, I would insert that here. The Red Magic 10 Pro does have an optical underscreen fingerprint scanner, which when burdened by the weight of level 7 deeper grooves, continues to function like normal, unlocking the phone every single time. So thumbs up for that. Finally, there's a shortage of perfect phones in this world, and it would be indeed a shame to damage this one, but as true gamers know, maxing out your power does no good if you still have level 1 armor. Luckily for Red Magic, this new 10 Pro is packing on multiple levels, and has no flex when bent from the front, and zero movement when bent from the back. No kinks, creaks, or damage whatsoever. The Red Magic 10 Pro is really just a keyboardless gaming laptop packed into a smartphone form factor with specs that iPhone users will hopefully get to enjoy themselves 10 years from now. Red Magic is finally going mainstream and launching this phone in 30 different countries. Nice work, Red Magic. Leave a comment, any comment down below, and I'll pick a random commenter to get the untouched Dusk. Things are done for watching. I'll see you around.